city. How about using that technology to give people counseling? Right? That was the idea. No big plan. We didn't know it was going to work. What then happened was, we then actually went and we launched it without having a product. We literally went to a school, and I remember going to the school and we asked the principal, give us the 10 worst kids that you have. So the idea was, the people that currently was with us, with Art Labs, were all people that were ex-drug addicts, ex-drug dealers. So who best can talk about it than these guys and girls? I mean, they've been there. They've done that. They say, got the t-shirt. Got the t-shirt. Because they've got the scars and everything. Right? And literally, the principal wanted to give us off the school. He said, no, but we don't know what we're doing. We only need 10 kids. We started with 10 kids. A week later, there was 50 kids chatting to us. And we just told them, if you want to chat to us, add this contact as a buddy, like you would do on Google Chat or MSN or whatever. A month later, we had 100 kids. From there, this whole thing just exploded, right? And what we saw, and I mean, this is just an example of how I'll translate this for you if you can't read chat language, okay? And this was basically a message from one of the young people that just kind of said, thank you. So it's very typical we will get people that are suicidal or that's suffering from depression and all other kinds of things. But what we did, we used a technology that was available to them and we offered them support services. But the one thing we did realize, and I'll just quickly read this, this is someone who is basically saying thank you because they tried to commit suicide, they were on drugs, and now they're using poetry as a way of expressing themselves instead of using drugs. Okay, this is a thank you message. Of course, it's their own language that they talk. But what we realized in all of this was that there was a need. We could use better technology to meet the need. Then we decided to actually build a technology to manage all of these conversations because the numbers started to increase. Literally, from 10 kids 3 years ago, we've just surpassed to reach over 2 million people in the space of 3 years. So now we have over 2 million people using the platform that we developed right there on the Cape Flats. So our R&D was done not by a university professor, it was done by the most wanted for organized crime, ex-drug dealer. That was our research team mostly. We've got developers on board. And of course, thanks to the previous program that Christina was with, they gave us some seed funding so that we can take it to the next level, the whole program. Right? And this is basically just where you manage conversations. I can talk about this later. But this was a product that was developed in the community by people, for people. We then realized, but how about turning this product into a commercial product? Which we then did, and we then started with a startup. Right? And the product's name is called Jamix. And Jamix today, that's the name of it's actually Yami, it's a Swahili word.
Yeah.
What does it mean?
Community.
Community.
Yeah.
Society. Yeah. Okay. How do you pronounce it?
Yami.
No
stress. Yami.
Yeah. So the X is purely the word exchange. And so Yami is taken from Swahili, basically taking the thing about social exchange. And this is basically a startup company that we started out of that community project, along with the other two examples I gave you. And Jamix now is basically in, currently we've got agents that covers 11 countries. So not only are we based in Cape Town, we've also just been busy with a pilot where we're taking the product to Europe. We've got people that are using it in Indonesia, they're using it in South America, and we've basically turned it into a business. But it was a social idea that we then turned into an enterprise. And this whole thing, of course, has exploded, right? Beyond what we ever thought would be possible. We're now in the stages where we're now trying to do the, we've been to Silicon Valley, we've actually got an office in Silicon Valley as well, in the US. We've got someone that's constantly going up, trying to see kind of what kind of business opportunities are there for us. And our goal is basically within the next 3 to 4 years to to sell, right, the company and to raise as much money as we possibly can. So we're doing the whole kind of American thing with the product. But the idea is just taking an African product to the world, basically. And it wasn't, it was created, remember, in an unusual setting. That is important to remember. So the other thing we've learned about our labs is we have to be contagious. As technology entrepreneurs, you have to be contagious. You know what that means? You know when you have a disease and I give it to you, what's the word in Swahili?
Okiza.
What?
Okiza.
Okiza.
Really, right?
Yeah.
Okiza.
Oh, is that? So that's what you have to be. Not in the disease, but in your excitement in technology, innovation, creativity. And that's going to be very important. So for our labs, what was important was, as you have to be contagious. If you want to be a living lab, being contagious is important. Because the community needs to start thinking outside of the box. And I'm just going to wrap up quickly. This guy over here is Bring. Remember the guy I told you who had his mom around the neck and he wanted to kill him? That's his mother there. He taught his mother how to blog and to do Facebook now. So now they go about sharing his story. Right? And not all the people that we have are involved in gangs and drugs. Our labs now runs an academy where we've trained more than 3,000 people in the community around digital media, mobile and web development, and entrepreneurship. And personally, I've only trained 14 of that 3,000 plus people. The rest were all trained by the community themselves. And we're actually having our graduation of 300 people next week. Big graduation, right? Because the one thing we realized was we always have to celebrate people. Celebrating people is very important. So even if you do something and it's a failure, we celebrate it. We throw a party, you know? We make a big fuss of how amazingly good you were to not succeed with that venture. We celebrate it. And we don't go, oh, it didn't work. No, we're happy. Oh, it didn't work, it's good. We've learned some lessons here, right? Celebrating people is very important. That is some of the team. We currently employ 30 people in Cape Town, right? But that's not just where it ends. We then realize that we're not just about the Cape Flats anymore. We're not just about Cape Town anymore. Our labs has now grown to become a movement. In other words, what we've done is, since, I think it's now been for the last 18 months, we've gone from just being based in Cape Town to now growing into 14 countries. So it started there in that community that I painted earlier. No hope. And out of that, we've now basically grown into a movement covering 14 countries, of which, of course, we hope that we can do something exciting in Tanzania as well. Right? And we've now become a global movement. And our goal is to basically be on every continent by the end of 2012 and to reach a third of the world's population, which is now 2.2 something billion. It's a lot of people. But that's our goal as our labs. And what we do is we basically want to use innovation, creativity, to try and change the world. But of course we understand that it's always going to be about people first. It's about hope. It's about making sure that people have an opportunity to learn. And at the end of the day, our lab is all about this. It's about a social revolution. That is what it's about. So that is basically the journey of our lab. And of course, possibilities are endless. And I think that is basically all I wanted to share. And I think I went way over my time. But I just wanted to give you an insight into this kind of journey that we have as our labs. That never let your circumstances determine your destiny, basically. You know? That doesn't matter. It matters about, and it's not just about yourself either. That's the other thing you've learned. It's about how many people around you can actually lift up with you. Because people don't remember people that have great careers. There's a lot of amazing doctors and accountants. People don't remember them. They remember people who leave legacies. So try and leave a legacy. And you have an ideal opportunity in Tanzania.
Yeah.
There's so many things that you can do. And so many legacies that you can leave. Why not start by just doing one? And who knows where that might lead you to. So yeah, that's just if you want to learn about art labs and jammings. That's my Twitter handle, for those of you on Twitter. If you want to email me, feel free to do so. So yeah, so I'm